Hi, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now, today I want to ask, is it important to have your own domain on your email address? All right, so we have a few clients that they produce like tools and devices and things like that, and we write the apps that communicate with those devices. There's a lot of businesses that we work with in this way, and one of them has a device that's not yet finished yet, so it hasn't been created, but they know which Bluetooth chipset they're gonna use, and they want us to start on the development side of the app, before they're finished with the device, which means that we have to use the same chipset, right? Which is fine. We've done this before. So, they gave us a few, they gave us all the specifications and a few different suppliers that had the chipset, although most of them didn't have it in stock, but one of them was still, they still had it. It was like it's a Bluetooth low energy thing, right? And it's really cool though, actually, because you basically what happens is you plug it into USB and you plug the chipset into a board, right? Which comes with a board, and then you could send commands through the Bluetooth and you can see it like on a terminal on your PC. Anyway, that's not important, but it's cool if you get the chance to work with that kind of stuff, right? So anyway, I call up the company. So I go to the company's website, rather, and I find the development kit that I need to use, right? And I go and I add it to my basket. I go through checkout, and like on the third step, there's an error. Not an error due to anything I've done. It was just sort of like a website error. Like maybe they're running out of disk space. I have no idea what it was. It didn't make any sense to me, but these kind of things happen, and so that was fine. It wasn't a small company. According to their team page, they had 10, 15 people at least. You never know really. But it wasn't like a one person company. So anyway, so I could try back a few hours later thinking maybe they resolved it and they hadn't. So I thought, well, I'll just call their support line. So I go find the contacts, call up the support line, and the phone rings a few times and the person answers and says, "Hello." Right. And I say, is this XYZ company? Well, I don't remember what they were called. And she said, "Yeah, how can I help you?" And I said, "Okay, the website," and I explain it to her. She says they'll look into it on all this kind of stuff, and we hang up, right? Now, there were a few things that went wrong there. First of all, they had problems with their website. They weren't able to help me on support, all that kind of stuff. But the thing that bothered me the most about it, and I don't know why this did, was that she answered the phone by saying hello and not the name of the company. Right? It was just one of these little things that threw me off. It threw off the whole thing. Like it was just, I didn't know if I was phoning the right place. Right. And afterwards I thought about it and I thought, well, how she answered the phone was not important. It had no bearing on anything. Right. She could have been really helpful. The website could have been working, all this stuff. That had no bearing on anything, but still, it bothered me. It lacked a sense of professionalism. Like it wouldn't have costed anything else to answer the phone like professionally. Now, again, if this was like a one person, company or something like that, and they're working at a home, then I could understand that. But this was like a company. Like I called offices and they said, "Hello." It bothered me. Right? Now, this is the same kind of thing that bothers me when I get contacted by companies and their email address is like Gmail or Hotmail or Yahoo Mail, right? It's just one of these little things that's always kind of bothered me. Now, if somebody emails me like they're like a developer or they're an individual and they have, gmail.com, that I'm okay with, right? But a lot of times I get contacted by companies or, so-called companies, whatever. They might have a website, they might have, all this kind of stuff, but they have the Gmail address, right? And it's one of these little things that, it's not expensive to get a domain, and it's not expensive to hook up a domain with a Gmail I mean, we use Google apps for business. You can also set up other different domains, all this kind of stuff, right? But it's one of those little things that's not expensive to do, but it's just a little bit more professional. And I started thinking about like all the other ways that this kind of stuff. Like it doesn't have any bearings on how well they do their job, on the type of service they can give, all this kind of stuff. It's just one of those little things that just doesn't quite sit right with me. It puts doubts into my mind early on, right? It's a little bit the same as if you go to a job interview. Like if you go to a job interview and you're not dressed appropriately, you might not get the job. Now, how you're dressed has nothing to do with the job you do. It's just the impressions that you make to show that you're trying a little bit. And I was trying to think why this was bothering me. Why did this bother me? I tried to put it into words, right? I thought, like, let's say you're gonna call an electrician, right? Let's say you've got electrical problems in your house and you make three calls for electricians. The first guy shows up, he's just in his car, you know, he's got, he goes into the trunk, he's just wearing normal clothes, you know, t-shirt and jeans. He goes into his truck, he pulls out a few tools, he walks to the door, he knocks on the door, and when you answer it, he says, I hear you got a problem with your electricity, right? That's fine. The second guy comes up, he pulls up in his van, you know, the van has the name of his company on it, you know, he's wearing a shirt, but he may not be branded shirt or whatever. That's not really important, I don't think, right? But then he takes his tools and he answers the phone. He says, you know, hi, I'm Joe from Joe's Electricians. You know, you gave me a call. How can I help you? All that kind of stuff. And then the third guy shows up and he's in a really nice car and he comes up in a 3-piece suit and he doesn't have any tools and he says, I understand you have trouble with your electricity. Now, of those three people, which one would you choose, right? The guy who made no effort, the guy who made some effort, or the guy who made too much effort, right? Yeah. For me, I was trying to think, which one would I want to go with? And it would be the second one. It'd be the one who had a sense of professionalism about him, but wasn't trying too hard. Like, the third guy, for me, he wanted to be an electrician, or I think there's no way I can afford this guy or whatever. Or, you know, what is he, like an electrician to the stars or whatever? But, you know, the first guy who made no effort, which is the case a lot of times, it has no bearing on how well they do their job. You know, the first guy could be the best electrician, or the last guy could be the best electrician, but it's the second one who made the effort to those little things that just sort of, they just put me at ease that I was spending my money wisely. So this is my question to you, because I know this, I've talked to a lot of people about this in the past where they say, you don't really need a website, you don't need a domain name, you don't need business cards, none of that stuff is important. It's just, knowing the right people and meeting the right people. And I know other people who spend way too much time on that kind of stuff. Like, they spend all their time setting up the website, doing the business cards, not enough time finding clients. And I think it's sort of a happy medium in between, So I want to ask you guys today, for this weekend, do you think it's important to have a domain name? Do you think it's important to have a website? If you're going to work with clients, or if you're going to, even do app support, all that kind of stuff, even just as a company. A lot of you guys are setting up your own companies, or you have your own companies. Do you feel that kind of stuff is important, or do you think it's all overhyped? Right. So anyway, those are just my thoughts for today. I hope you guys have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you guys on Monday.